Hello everybody, this is Vinton, aka BitB, and welcome out to another BitB stream. Oh, damn. Great. So apparently this save file didn't have the animated intro in it. Fuck! Good to know. Hold on a second. I can fix this. Boy, in case you were wondering, I've had a rough couple of weeks. Actually, just a rough, like, couple of hours here. Hold on. We are not getting through this until I fix the animated intro. There we go. I swapped it over, like, a really long time ago, so there's certain presets that just don't have it set up right now. That is unfortunate. Here. There, that is what it's supposed to do when I start this thing up. Sorry about that. Anyway, thanks for coming out to the stream. It is Wednesday, and this is, like, sort of the retro game sort of thing, and normally I try to go, like, really retro with this stuff, but I, for the life of me, cannot possibly think of anything, like, really retro for today, so I figured today would be a good day to just jump into the very first GameCube game that we've ever done on the stream. Specifically, we're thinking about, like, I'm going to be doing Pac-Man World 2, which is not the greatest video game of all time, but at the very least, like, it's interesting. Like, it's much better than Pac-Man World 3, I will say. but I will say, I don't know if you can notice this or not, but I am kind of sick. You could probably hear it in my voice. If I like, break into coughing fits, I really apologize. I think, I'm fairly certain I caught bronchitis for my brother. It's like, which kind of sucks, but, you know what? I'm not gonna have that stop me from streaming tonight. That's for certain. And as long as I drink plenty of water, I've already taken Advil, so that should be kicking in momentarily. Crossing my fingers. But yeah, water. As much water as I possibly can. Now, you can probably tell. Like, I can tell just by listening to myself. I'm raspy as all fuck. So, all right. Anyway, I figured we would start this one off by by actually starting up the GameCube proper. Just for the nostalgia sake of it. Oh, hold on a second.
No, that's not right. No, we need to see, like,
the actual animated intro, dude. Here. Click. Yeah, just to start this off right. I don't know, it's really interesting to think that something like this could be considered nostalgic nowadays. Actually, I saw this one post, I forget where it was, but somebody, I think it was like Imgur or something, somebody posts, like, when you realize that, like, this year makes 2006 a decade ago. And I just kind of sat there and got very sad. So if you think about it, like, this thing's like 14 years old, or at the very least. It's been out for a while. I think, did the GameCube come out in like 2001 or 2002? Is it something? I know that Pac-Man World 2 came out in 2002, I think. It says so, like, copyright-wise on the back of the box. Anyway, let's actually start this son of a bitch. There, put the CD in. Also, on a side note, I don't know if anybody is, if anybody knows, like, the 3DS skins thing that they got going on. You know, where you can, like, buy custom skins and all that jazz. And I was always really interested in that, but the one thing that I really, really wanted out of that was skins of previous iterations of Nintendo hardware. I mean, there's plenty of stuff that's based off of things like, you know, the old NES games, like the original Super Mario Brothers. But, like, what I wanted to see is some menus based on, like, old hardware menus. And let me tell you, like, this, if they released this as a skin for the 3DS, I'm buying it immediately. I am picking this up because I really want to see this cube in, like, 3D. Then it's kind of a nod to the whole fact that Nintendo GameCube was supposed to try the whole 3D thing. Like, I don't know. The original concept behind the 3DS started off from taking a GameCube and then connecting, like, a 3D screen to it. But it was so impractical, and it required so much shit that it's just like, well, I don't think it's gonna work, guys. How about we just make this a console? And that was probably for the better, because the GameCube was kind of the last video game console that they actually gave two shits about. And actually felt like you're playing video games as opposed to a video game made for grandma. Anyway, yep, Pac-Man World 2. Let's get that shit started. Licensed by Nintendo. And one of the other reasons why I'm starting out with this game is because I have the suspicion that I'm not going to have too many problems with content ID on anything here. No previous save game found on memory card. Yeah, I actually wiped it just for the sake of doing this episode. So yeah, absolutely. Which, by the way, I'm currently using my my graphics card. You know, my really old-ass graphics card. Actually, no, not graphics, sorry. Sorry, my brain's still stuck in graphics. Memory card, that's what it is. I'm using my memory card from, like, a really long time ago. Anyway, let's watch this little cutscene. I've completely forgotten what this cutscene even is. Jeez. You gotta love how, like, somebody actively... Some company was actively hired to make these pre-animated cutscenes for this game. Let's see. So, I guess the ghosts are up to no good or some crap. And I guess Pinky has some weird crush on Pac-Man somehow. I don't know. Clyde, everyone's just kind of... Everything's going wrong all at once. You might as well just get the fuck out now. Yep. Run! Run for your life! Aw, he got pricked by the tree. Oh, yeah, they all get together and they steal the fruit in the middle of town. The golden tree fruit. Of course, they don't realize what evil they're unleashing. What are you doing? Don't juggle. You do not understand the hell you've opened up. We will see that hell in just a second. Dum-dee-dum-dee-dum. Yeah, Peggy realizes, like, hurricane? Tornado? Tsunami? Yeah. Just everybody stop what you're doing. We might have done fucked it.
At last, I am free from the confines of this accursed prison. You then take these golden fruit that imprisoned me and follow me if you want to get rid of these pack people forever.
I really want to know who voice acted that. I want to just talk to the guy and just be like, how much did they pay you? $20. Any dear, let's go ahead and just start a new game. There we go. Let's see. Game one. I could literally have three save slots, seriously. Okay. Oh, sorry. Sorry. There it goes. And now it's morning. And now Pac-Man has to deal with all of this bullshit. You remember when this used to look...
Oh, terrible, wait a minute. Terrible news! Pac-Man is in serious danger. The ghosts have unwittingly unleashed an ancient evil upon us by removing the golden fruit from the tree. According to this book...
We really should take closer inspection of that tree. Why don't we have guards around it? I don't fucking know.
Wizard Pac created a powerful potion that turned five fruit from Pac-Land into the golden fruit that was stolen today. Armed with these magical fruit and a great deal of bravery, Sir Pac-a-Lot faced the all-powerful ghost...
This is some horse shit.
Sir Pac-a-Lot defeated Spooky and imprisoned him. And he has remained there...
Under a tree.
...until now. Fruit are in the hands of the devious ghosts, and Spooky is on the loose again.
Okay,
you must retrieve the golden fruit.
It's like this guy keeps talking. Shut the fuck up.
Pac-Land will be doomed.
Gotcha. Jeez. Again, Toshio Love, like, a long time ago, all of these visuals, like, genuinely looked just brand new, like, space age and all this jazz. I remember I was playing the N64, and the N64, and I thought, wow, this is amazing. And then the GameCube got there, and, like, the Xbox and that. And, like, for every single generation, you don't think it could get any better, and then the next one does get better. It's just like, how the fuck do they do it? Real quick, though, I'm actually going to adjust my headset because for whatever reason, it's stupidly loud. Even though it's, like, set to absolute zero. Here. Nope, enough of that. It's a good thing I have manual controls over this headset, otherwise I would be having some serious problems. Okay, is this the main volume? Good. Alright, we should be good to go. Pac-Man, welcome to Pac Village, the heart of Pac-Land. You have a long adventure ahead of you, but you can always return home for some diversion. Yep, because as all Pac-Man games work, you can collect stuff and that will unlock games inside of a Pac-Man arcade. Because why the fuck not? On to more important matters. Here's a health wedge. Eat these, it'll give you... I don't fucking do it. Like, it's so weird and so abstract that, like, so many of these items are just like, it's a piece of your face! It's like... And pack dots, because what Pac-Man game would be without them? I'll tell you what Pac-Man game it would be. It would be, like, Pac-Man 2. Actually, wait, did Pac-Man 2 have pack dots? I forget. I don't think it did. No, we played it a while ago, and instead it was just collecting fruit in the time span allotted until you get caught by something. And then extra life. And there's a token. You need to collect enough of those and you'll unlock games inside the arcade. And maybe later on we'll go back to the arcade and take a look around. Here's the exit from Pac Village. And then that's a power pellet. Again, this is all kind of rudimentary Pac-Man type stuff, but, you know, in case you were a five-year-old and had not, like, been informed or taught about the packs of men. Let's see. Oh, boy. Hold on one second. See, I'd set this up so that... Yeah, I had set this thing up so that I would just be playing it off of the XSplit monitor, but... Oh, it's not working. it's really not working. I think... I'm gonna have to do some, like, real quick live splicing here to get it working on, like, this monitor over here. So, hold tight real quick. I will figure that out. What do I do? Actually, I think a good way to do that would be... Hold on. Plug it in here. Okay. Let's see. Did that work? Let us see. I hope it worked. Screen might be, like, stretched all to hell, but... I definitely want to have this thing lagless. HDMI, no signal? Fuck that. What do you mean, no signal? I have this set up on a splitter. What the fuck? Am I gonna have to reroute this another way? Oh, God, don't you hate... I hate live fixing things right on the spot. Especially when I'm sick, that doesn't help me out. Let's see, it should be HDMI. Theoretically. Maybe it's just the... You know, I'm gonna disconnect the video feed, and then I'm gonna try and reconnect it. There. The video should be disappearing for you guys. Yep, and now my Elgato is freaking the fuck out, because it's just like, what did you do? What did you unplug? It's okay, Elgato, I got it. Come on, please work. Come on, work. I can't deal with this right now. Ah, shit.
That doesn't seem to be working all that well.
Can you notice that a whole bunch of this is just kind of like right on the spot? Like I kind of just came up with the idea and just decided, ah, this will work.
Okay, well that being said, what can I do? Oh, Jesus.
I just noticed that the HDMI cord's actually unplugged on the other side. Fuck me, okay. We need a longer HDMI. What the hell, man? You know what? That is easy to get. I will be, you know, I'm gonna BRB and get all this stuff like set up and ready to go. So you guys just hang tight. All right, that took a stupidly long amount of time, but we're done. We got it. And I have it rigged up on the other monitor. It's looking crisp, looking fine. Fuck me, all right. Let's see, all right, let's try to actually play the game now, which involves going and collecting a whole bunch of dots in a 3D environment. There, my chair got all fucked up. Oh, man. Yeah, I don't remember this game being, like, all that great. But, like, it was definitely, like, the best Pac-Man world out of there, like, out of the lot. Like, I tried Pac-Man World 3. Oh, oh, that was just kind of a lame son of a bitch. Like, it was a whole lot of just me not caring. Like, I don't remember entirely what made me so upset about it, but I think it was just there's a lot of mechanics in there, and it all felt kind of bland. To be fair, like, this feels kind of bland, but Pac-Man World 3 is, like, an entire different genre of bland. Anybody else? Can anybody out there vouch for Pac-Man World 3? Honestly, I'd like to hear if anybody would, like, if anybody really defends it and really enjoys it. Because there's always that one group that really actually, like, really enjoys a video game. For whatever really ridiculous reason. Collecting the fruit. See, I believe there's some, like, really difficult way of getting up here. I think I remember it now. What? And, oh, Jesus. Fuck. Okay, I think it was you're supposed to grab onto the... Yeah, the telescope. Oh, Jesus. Come on, you bastard. Down, nope. Damn it. I hope there's not too much of this in my playthrough of Pac-Man World 3. No, Pac-Man World 2. Sorry. Sorry, my head's stuck in that. I'm still sick. Don't judge me. Damn it. But yeah, let's try and get up here. How about that? Okay. Alright, did it. And got the token. Do I get anything special for collecting everything on the stage? Like, this is very much one of those, like, you know, one of those games where every single thing, or every single world has got, like, some shit that you gotta collect. Oh fuck! I forgot that those were bad. Well, hi, how you doing? I squashed him. Okay, I see another token up here. Goddamn mosquitoes! What the fuck? I just had a mosquito like on my arm, sucking blood. It's just like, what the fuck? Where'd you come from? It's actually been a while since I've had a mosquito genuinely bite my arm. For whatever reason, like, whenever mosquitoes tend to get in here, I don't know why, but wherever I live, like, where I live right now, the mosquitoes are dumb as a post. They tend to just get into your house, and then once they're in their house, it's just like, alright, I'm here! Now what the fuck do I do? And then they just fly around trying to bounce off all the walls instead of trying to suck blood. Like they are supposed to be, but... No, this guy actually hit the balls to try and suck some blood out of me, and he kind of succeeded. I'm looking forward to when that starts to itch. Great. Nope. What the fuck? That was another problem with this game. The camera controls, not the best. Hello. Oh yeah, this is that tiny area with all the little extra bits. I'm just showing things off. There's a lot of these tokens in town. Wow. Yeah, I do need to go go to that arcade and see just how much I can. There we go. Need to go to that arcade and see. Yep. How much is unlocked? Fuck. Are you serious? Come on. There. Fuck shit. Platformers, why? Alright, anyway, let's go ahead into the arcade. See, like, I mean, I have got 6 tokens, maybe some stuff is unlocked. I'm not gonna care too much about playing any of this stuff. Let's see, you could play these games by collecting tokens. Yeah, I know how it works. There's Pac-Man. Pac-Attack. In case you absolutely love the soundtrack, which, by the way, hilariously, it's the exact same melody constantly over and over and over and over and over again. Let's see, Pac-Mania, which, again, that's kind of one of my favorite Pac-Mans, just because, like, it really did kind of feel like just Pac-Man, except you had a little bit more chance in getting yourself out of a situation. You just need to be able to jump. And Miss Pac-Man. Wait, what? Play the... Oh, right. Pac-Man World 2 has a bunch of little mini mazes and stuff. I forgot about that. Wow. Seriously? Like, that's all that's in here? Jesus. Like, it's kind of bare bones. Like, a lot of other Pac-Man games would add just a ton more of these things. Like, you know, the Pac-Man Museum thing that I got? I mean, to be fair, that directly, actively tries to just package a whole bunch of games in one thing. And this arcade's just kind of a bonus area. No real necessity for it. It's just like, hey, you collected a bunch of tokens. Here, play an old-ass game. We swear this is Pac-Man? All right. Yeah, why not? Just to make sure. Again, sorry. For anybody who has recently joined the stream, I want to inform you guys right now, I'm actually kind of sick. So, not doing all that great, but hey, God forbid, I'm not gonna stop streaming just because bronchitis is kicking my ass, but I can survive. Anyway, now we're here. Hi, how you doing? Yeah, listen closely to the melody here. Same one from the last area. And literally, like, only 2 or 3 other songs within this entire game that follow any other kind of melody. I mean, I guess I might be expecting a little bit too much from Pac-Man World, but... Oh, it's just weird. And a little bit tedious. Oh, no, this is very much just a... Run, collect game, you don't have to worry too much about... You don't overthink anything, and that's kind of why I wanted to start out with this one. Or, like, why I wanted to play this today specifically, because, like... Oh, yeah, I need a game where I don't think all that... like, all that hard, or... There. Genuinely, like, my brain power is completely dead. And also another reason why I picked this game as opposed to anything else is, I was thinking about doing Super Mario Sunshine, because, oh god, that's my favorite Mario game of all time. It's basically Super Mario 64, except it looks amazing. And I really wish they would make another Mario game like that, instead of just the space stuff. Like, a lot of people really enjoyed the space type things, but I couldn't get into it. I don't know, it just sort of made my brain go absolutely sideways. It's like, how the fuck is this working? It's like, oh, right, I forgot about this. Hold the B button. Zoom! Oh, right, this is a button. This game did have some pretty cool mechanics. I could see... Here's the thing, I could definitely see a game like this being speedrun. Like, you know, like some kind of a speedrun on it. Specifically for a whole lot of these mechanics that they have. Yeah, you know, just like, how long do I hold the boost? How long do I, you know, how high... should I jump? I'm willing to bet that speedruns on this game would actually be pretty cool. Oh, Jesus. Thank you, camera. But anyway, yeah, I really wanted to play Super Mario Sunshine, but I kind of looked at that and I'm like, Pac-Man World 2, there's a lot less chance that I'm going to get content ID'd for something here. Oh, right, I can kick in the air, right? I forgot about that. Whoop-ow! I love that. Yeah, meanwhile, like, yeah, Super Mario Sunshine, direct Nintendo IP. No. Okay, and then you can swim under the water. Is there any way to break those boxes? Or... it looks like I can breathe indefinitely. Right, let's go back to the surface, because meh. Honestly, I'm probably not going to be collecting every single little trinket in this game, because I don't care enough. But I'll try and collect as much as I possibly can. But... oh, Metal Pac-Man! Right, so I'm trying to remember, what does the Metal Pac-Man upgrade do for me? Anything in particular? Oh, hi, how you doing? Bang! Cool. Oh, sorry. My lungs, they are on the fire. Okay, let's move on to the next world. Yeah, like, I'm really interested in jumping into a lot of other games. Like, I'm interested in trying out stuff like Xbox and GameCube type stuff. I never really owned, like, I mean, we owned the PlayStation 2, but we did not do a whole lot of stuff with it. Like, we basically owned 5 games, and we ran the lottery on whether or not we would get good games for the PlayStation. We did not. We ended up getting some pretty shitty stuff. And I have no fucking idea why. Like, let me think of some of them. We ended up getting the Power Rangers Dino Force game. Oh, that was fucking awful. Like, that is a game that just does not tell you enough about what the hell you're supposed to do. Hey, how you doing? Leave me alone. Here, fuck you. Oh, let's see what else. I think we might have owned Need for Speed Underground 2 for it. Like, maybe. I could be wrong. We could have owned it for the GameCube, maybe. And I seem to recall we owned like all 3 of the. Oh, what the fuck? Get the hell out of here! This game's actually kind of challenging. Like, I've already lost like 2 wedges of health. What the hell? Let's see, there's something up here. Oh, is that a token? Woo! How can I get that? Oh my god! Scary. Alright, got the checkpoint. Anyway. Yeah, I think we basically just voted with whatever we actually managed to get our hands on. Oh my god. I should probably get the fuck out. I need to get a little bit higher if I'm gonna kick that guy's ass. How would I do that, by the way? Yeah, oh, Jesus. Nope, okay, yeah, I've had enough. I'm done with that. Oh, hello. The hell are you, lizard man? Alright, good. He dies like everything else. Right, is there some easy way to kill that guy? Nah, I'm not interested enough. Hey, how you doing? Weird doggy thing. Fuck! Urgh. I bounced on him. Oh well. Well, we hit the checkpoint, so yeah, it's no big deal. Oh, I'm trying to think what other games came out for like the GameCube and the Xbox that we could try and play on the stream. Honestly, like most of the games for the GameCube and for the Xbox, we've pretty much lost. Like, they're probably sitting in some box somewhere. Like, that's the most likely. the most likely place that they are at. Ooh. Oh. Ooh. Okay. All right. Oh, that's how you get the token. Neato. I was wondering about that. It's like, how? What? Why? Alright, now to get past this guy. I suppose the easiest way to do this would be going around. Oh, Jesus! Ugh. Okay, never mind. Fuck that guy. We don't need to get everything. Although, I guess the tokens have kind of sentimental value to me because they do represent the arcade. And it does mean that I can unlock a whole bunch of the machines in there. It's really useless because I own Pac-Man Museum. I can play those games at any point in time. On a really shitty, like, packaged version of Pac-Man Museum, or, you know, just Namco Museum in general. Pick that up. Oh, let me think. What other GameCube games did I play? I do not remember. A huge portion of the games that we played for the GameCube were just stuff that we rented from the local, like, video store. You know, because there was always a video store that was connected directly to, like, whatever grocery store you went to. So I'm trying to remember some of the games that we played on there. Oh, shit, that's a ghost. Oopsies. Excuse me. Nom. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Get. Stop moving. There. What the hell did those things remind me of? Is it like, the bubble bobble guys? Yeah, like that's what they remind me of. Oh, Jesus. A cartoon honk sound effect. Damn it. Come on. I want a cherry. What the fuck? There. And now I can't even reach that edge of the cliff. God damn it. It's okay. I made it past. There. Forward. March. Okay. Where are they? I remember quite a few times when I was just passing through the store. During the N64 days, I passed by the box art for Glover. Oh, God. Even when I was a kid, I saw that. It's like, oh, that looks like shit. Oh, what the fuck? Ah! What the hell? I'm running out of lives! I cannot be this shit. Okay, apparently I am this shit. Seriously? What happens when I run out of lives? Like, I'm actually genuinely curious at this point. Like, it can't be all that punishing. It's probably just like, oh, game over. Now you're gonna have to start the whole level from the start. I do remember there were a few levels that were, like, oddly unnaturally unfair. Okay, grab that. And now to kick all these guys' asses. Yoink! Right. Add another token. Oh, right, I need to do this first. And I'm like, this is precisely why I wanted to make sure that I had a full legless preview monitor, because it is a platformer, and I do remember that some of these jumps are pixel perfect timing. I don't know why I didn't think about that, because, yeah. Ooh. Howdy, how you doing? Okay. Move the camera down. Squash. Why do they have green blood? I wonder if maybe in Japan the blood was like red, or, you know, red. But they had to change it for America, probably. Or I could be talking directly out of my ass. That's also possible. Yoink, yoink. Okie doke, Jesus. God, this game is slippery as all hell. Right. Do I care about the orange? I guess so. Alright, don't fall over this time. than this thing. Shrinks me for whatever reason. I don't think that power-up shows up anywhere else in this game. Like, just this one area. Alright, save. I'm trying to remember how you... I think you're supposed to find the, what is that one thing called? I don't know, like, it's one of those Pac-Man collectibles, and it turns out to be one of the classic mazes. Yeah, there it is, the weird wing thing. And I guess there was, a maze there at some point. Howdy. Stand still! I'll say killing enemies in this game doesn't require all that much thought. Okay. Let's try and get up here. Yeah, nope. Didn't do that right. Nope. You know what? Fuck it. I don't care. Damn it, I mean, sure. There we go. Heading back. That's fine. Thank you. Now I can actually collect all this stuff. Neat. See, and again, like the exact... same melody again. Do 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 do. Like, who the hell was the composer for this game? He really phoned that shit in. He's just like, oh, this is a pretty good deity. Let's reuse it 20 times. I mean, like, I'm gonna be fair with him on this. There are certain composers that do reuse a hell of a lot of melodies. I mean, there is some science behind that. You know, like, there is such a thing as game theming. And having, like, really... I don't know, when a franchise is really well known for specific ditties, it actually makes sense to reuse them in certain situations. So I get that. It's just this one... This game reuses it constantly. Where the hell do I go? Screw it, just keep moving. Eventually this will lead you to where you're supposed to be. Hello, fruit. Yoink. I've already collected all of the strawberries. Okay, oh, hey, here we go. Nom 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 nom. Ugh, sorry. Again, sick as all fuck. What am I supposed to do here? To stop in the middle of a rev roll, press the A button. Oh, I'm supposed to rev roll over this. Okay. I get you. Alright. I just need to remember to do that the next time that I try to do a rev roll. Another one of these. Oh, shit! Urgh. Close, no cigar. I can do it again. Okay, grab this apple over here. Oh, what other... because we played the ever-loving hell out of both GameCube and Xbox, and I'm trying to remember what games we played on it. I think I remember we played this, like, weird Bruce Lee video game. Which was odd as hell. Wow. Saved my skin there. Boink. Let's try and get that without dying. Got it. In general, I think not dying would be the appropriate thing to do here. Yeah, I don't know why those things remind me of the little bubble bobble guys. They don't look exactly like them. They look like this weird combination between the bubble bobble dinosaur and Goombas. And again, I ended up missing that... I guess every single one of these worlds has one of those hidden maze things. Oh, shit. Pac-Man! Spooky says you can't have that golden fruit thingy. My big froggy tongue should get ya. As long as you don't butt bounce on it. in case I was 5 years old and they couldn't quite figure that out. Alright, bring it the hell on. Oh, jeez. Ah, fuck. Alright. I believe he comes back later on and it requires me to actually roll directly into the uvula. Hold still, there we go. There you go. My big froggy tongue! I'll get you with something you can't break. Let's see how you deal with steel. And don't even think of rave rolling. What the fuck? What's that glowing thing in his... This game was made for 5-year-olds. What the fuck? I completely forgot that that was even a thing. Come on. Like, I'm not that stupid. Like, most video games, it's real easy for, like, how little faith did they have in their own video game where they're just like, oh, we didn't telegraph that right. Let's just directly tell the player what to do. Of course, I don't know. Maybe they beta tested it with some American customers. They're just like, oh, hey, wait a minute. People don't understand what the fuck to do. Never mind. The Golden Cherry. That is interesting to think about. Like, I've always wondered what it... Like, I've never been in sort of any designer type of things, but it is weird to consider that there are people that they do hire just for the sake of playing a video game, watch them, and just be like, okay, they did not fucking understand what the hell we were trying to do here. How can we make it more obvious? And I feel like they cheaped out a little bit. Okay. I think this is one of my favorite levels right here. Because of these bouncy pads. Boing. Blurr. Okay, except that one had... Yeah, bang. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, that one had a safety net, just in case, like, you fucked up. Alright, got the checkpoint. What's inside the box? What's in the box? Cherry. What do you do? Ugh, damn it. Sorry. Sick. Okay, more of these things. So I'm trying to listen to the tone, just the theme in this world. Because I think it's a remake of that one tune before. Okay, maybe not. I think this is one of the rare exceptions where you got a different song. Yeah, that works. I've gotten 21 tokens. I wonder how many I need in order to actually, like, play things. Cool, cool. I like tree levels like this. You don't see nearly enough of them in video games. But they're oddly inventive. It sort of feels like going to the Ewok planet. The hell did I just hit? Okay. Oh. Oh, what? I'm confused. What? Am I supposed to go back and hit that, or? I guess so. I don't know. Let's go back. Because I saw that was depressed. It was just like, did I press that down, or did I, like, completely miss point there? Jump. Not dead yet. Doing fine. Ah, cool. Alright, now what's all this about? Is this just gonna lead me all the way back up there? It's just like, we've hidden all the pack dots. Better find them over here. I'm so tired. It's like, I'm very tired. Okay, here, let me try this. Oh, fuck! No, no, no! Wow, that was close. I guess now I have to climb all the way back up. God damn it. That's what I don't like about these levels. Like, they're real tall. You can save yourself. But at this point, I might as well just jump off because I got the checkpoint. Alright, well, let's try and do this straight and true this time. Whoa. What's up? What the heck is this? Am I supposed to have, like, all of the apples before I can get this thing? Damn it. Alright. Where does this lead me? Boing. Just cartoon sound effects. Grabbing that. I completely forget what those chests are for. Maybe it is you're just supposed to collect all of one particular fruit and then that chest will be available to open. I don't need the extra life, I'm fine. I might need it in just a little bit, but for now, I'm okay. Butt stop! And we're there. Okay, I think I have enough momentum that I can get over there this way. Bang! Oh, Jesus. You guys are ghosts. Supposed to be for a second. Thank you. Okay, right. Oh, come on, more of you. Narf. Alright, what do we need to be looking for here? Well, let's get the checkpoint over here. Oh, oh, what the fuck? Fuck you, asshat. Yeah, I feel like I should probably just run. It's really, like, it's really tempting to just run throughout this entire thing and get every single one of the pack dots, but as I've gotten older playing video games, I don't care anymore. Just, like, oh, I forgot to save. Shit. Ah, whatever, I'll save later. No, genuinely, it just feels so... Especially video games that I've played over and over and over and over again. There's another factor to it. Owie. Oh, they reused this for, like, the second part of the woods. Except they added more drunk trumpet. Yeah, as I've gotten older, just I look at a whole lot of things that video games do, and I'm just... Oh, fuck. Damn. Shit. How many lives do I have left? I think 5, 6? I think I'll be okay. Yeah, I got 5. It's cool. Yeah, I don't know. I think it's just the fact that collection quests like this, it's real easy to just pass over everything after you've done it perfectly one time. Or, like, gotten real close to doing it perfectly one time. And that was this game for me. Like, I had gone through everything. I had completed it, 100%ed. Fuck it. But I don't really care about collecting all this shit again. You know, like, I've got much bigger things to do. Like, I think I say this all the time, just like, I don't feel too much like an adult, but I am an adult. As immature as fuck I am, like, I am an adult. I have bills to pay, things to do, people to see, other things to concern myself with, and, like, this video game where I collect a whole bunch of stuff, no. I will say, if another collection quest comes out at some point later on in history, then I'd totally be for it. What was down here? I seem to remember those. Yep, something here. Click. The hell that did? Alright, let's go see. Oh, yep. No. Where am I going with this? Dum bum 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 bum. Where am I going? Jesus. I'm getting a lot of pack dots, that's nice. Oh, ooh, nice, token. Bounce. Okay, now I'm back over here. Let's jump on now. Ow, shit. And I collect all the oranges. Whoa! Boing. Sorry. Throat. I'm trying my best not to cough directly into the microphone. Because that sounds dreadful. Shit! Oh no! He's fine. He's fine. Checkpoint! Yes! Okay, what do we got over here? Some more maze type things. Joint. Joint. I've collected all the cherries. Orange. Fuck that apple. Do not care enough for that apple. Oh, but wait a minute, what's up here? A melon? Now, oddly enough, one of the parts of this game I actually really do enjoy is those hidden mazes that you can collect. Which is funny, because, like, it's the littlest amount of work possible, but yeah, the platforming, it just kind of run by the numbers, like, it does what it's supposed to do, and I guess it does enough to keep you interested, you know, with the whole butt bounce mechanic stuff, like, that's cool. But for me, it doesn't do nearly enough to actually warrant it existing, which, yeah, that's unfortunate to say, I'm really mean, but that's just how I feel. Another checkpoint. I am running on empty, and I am hitting a whole bunch of checkpoints. Oh god. Fuck you. Fuck you, bear. Okay, there's another one of these hidden things over here. Let's go down and see what we can find. Oh, whoopsies. Come on down. What the fuck? Ugh! God damn it. Seriously? Like, that did not seem like a death fall. Okay, this way. This is the end. And what can we find over here? Boing. Boing. Am I going all the way back over here? A little scared. This is taking me really far away. What the fuck? Okay. Whatever. Okay, made it back over here. Wait a minute. Is this all the way back at... Oh, are you serious? It brought me back just for the sake of me getting a token. Hooray for artificial lengthening of a video game! That's really what it is. This is like, when you need to keep the difficulty fair, just put in a whole bunch of pitfalls that make you go all the way back to the beginning. I'm not gonna... I was gonna say, just like, it's not the beginning, but you get what I mean. Okay, well, we can make it back from here, right? I think we might actually be back. Nope. This can't possibly be healthy. Just random-ass pack dots that are, like, growing off the sides of a tree. Okay, can I get this without killing myself? Woo-hoo-hoo! Yes, very close. Right, now where? I gotta jump over there now. Okay. It's weird because I'm sort of partly remembering the entirety of this game, but like not 100%. It's strange. Cause I haven't played these games in like 10 years. Right, let's move on. Oh great, butane pain. This is the weird log thing, right? Like the log enemy. right? Oh, wait, nope. I think I might have gotten that wrong. Fuck. Oh, right, so this'll... Goddamn camera. Like, the camera swapped over and I was, like, next to the edge. Oh, right, fire. So, maybe I'm crazy, but I feel like having jets of fire coming out of a tree is not a good idea. And whoever designed this has got some major problems. Okay, oh! Right. So now I gotta get back there if I want to get something special. But by now, yep, I am back to normal Pac-Man. Can I shut off the fire? Okay, good. Why is that fall hurt? Jesus. Come on, Pac-Man. You can do better than that. Oh, you... Jesus. The momentum on this bastard. There's a token. Oh, I really honestly do not care. I could play every single one of those Pac-Man games in, like, much sharper quality through, like, Pac-Man Museum. Which is not, you know, not great ports, but... Alright, let's head the hell out. Oh god, so much fire. Yay, gluttony! Okay, right. Actually, I think... I wonder if I can ramp myself over here. Damn you, spider. And then, well, I can't break that. Shit. Can I reach up here? I don't think so. This is just a rope. Okay, but I can get myself up here, though. This feels dangerous as all fuck. Alright, let's try. Let's do it. Whoa, my... Jesus. Close. I'm having, like, this weird deja vu while playing these levels. Like, so many of them are so similar. Like, they use the exact same assets for all of the tree trunks coming off the trees and all that jazz, so it really does feel like you're just redoing all the levels all over again. Except now you have a slightly different remix to the music. Boing. Alright, let's just keep moving. Not too concerned with collecting everything. Yoink. I would like to know where some of those mazes are located. I'd like to find those, and I would like to play them. And my invincibility is gone. Oh, good. Not interesting. Oh, hey, cool. Brr. Get this away. Boy, I'm really glad that they actually spaced these things really well. Because just, I imagine... Another one of those buttons that I can come back and press. Now, I do imagine, like, a situation where the programmers were like, okay, let's try and space them. Oh, ow, 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 what the fuck? Ah, shit, nope. The hell, man? Oh, okay. Oh, okay. I'm a dumbass, gotcha. I understand perfectly now. It's like, hey, look! Jump directly into the fire! Okay, oh, that opened up whatever the hell. Yeah, turned off all the fire. And now I gotta get to that button. This can be done! Bump, bump, bump. Now, for as many criticisms as I've had of this game, I will say at the very least, that this game does, it's at least fun. Like, the physics are just good enough that when you fail, it's usually the fault of yourself and not the game itself. One or two times I've kind of, like, careened directly off the edge due to the camera putting, you know, like, readjusting at the completely wrong angle. But for the most part, it's, like, the game's physics are perfectly fine. Let's stop over here for a second. Oh my god! Ah, I'm token. Jesus. Don't surprise a man like that. Ow. I don't know if there's any easy way to kill those guys, so fuck it. Okay, checkpoint. I'm collecting a lot of tokens from these guys. Dun, 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 dun. I do like how the access for the Nintendo GameCube controller, like, it has very, it's oddly specifically sharp. You know, like, how, like, for instance, for a lot of, like, new controllers, like, I have the Xbox One controller sitting right here. It's, like, perfectly smooth all around. So, like, you have no, like, specific one-on-one directions, but a cool thing about the GameCube controller is that, and this was utilized by a lot of developers, is that if you push it far enough, like, forward, then, yeah, you do lock into kind of a more specific axis, which is, it's nice. Like, if you're, I have it, like, right in front of me. I don't know if you guys have a GameCube controller on you as well, but I always kind of like that because it does make platforming like this a little bit easier. That way. God, I'm getting so much fucking deja vu from this stuff. Like, I seriously feel like I have already fucking done this level. Like, it feels a little copy and paste from the last one. Right, let's hope the next level is a little bit more interesting. I collected all that shit. Oh, right, Inky's Blade-O-Matic. I believe now they literally just remake the exact same robot over and over and over again. Or at the very least, it was done twice. I know that, because Inky uses it, and I know Pinky uses it as well. Come for the golden fruit, Pac-Man! Spooky wanted me to think of a good cut-down if you ever got to me. I think my saw blade should do the trick. That contraption doesn't look very strong. Some rev rolls into the body or butt bounces on the glass should do the trick. Are you listening, five-year-olds? Okay. Oops. Jesus. Whoa. Okay, gotta find a good opportunity to actually roll into him, though. Yeah. You know, I'm actually gonna go over here. Oh, that didn't work. Okay, how would one do this then? Ouch, shit! Okay, that doesn't work. Do I just need to wait until he's done throwing his saw blades? Ow! Alright, well, I got him. Okay, maybe I gotta wait until... kinda just, like, throwing him haphazardly. Yeah! Bring it the fuck on. Wow! Bang. Cool.
Think you're pretty smart, don't you? I'll knock you off that platform.
Alright, this is the part where he starts... Up. Bang. Right, it's all about being at the, like, the right place at the right time, sort of. Oh, Christ. That was close. Come on. Line yourself up properly, asshole. Boink. Got him. This is a lot easier than when I was, like, a tiny little baby. Looks like you could still use a close shave. Bang. Alright, I got him. Hey, look at extra life. I will take that. Come on, bring it on. He can't even hit me from here. And slam! And now we get a cutscene. He's dead! Hooray! I got a golden strawberry. Sorry. Sorry. My throat. It cries for death. Alright, so now that I've gotten through there, now it's time to go into Snowland, which means slippery surfaces. That's going to be great for this control scheme. What? Who the hell is this? Wait a minute. Zoom in. Who the heck is it? Well, this guy looks fucking weird.
Pac-Man, it's great to see you! Everything around here has changed since Spooky and the Ghost stole the golden fruit. Ghosts have been seen all around the mountain. Watch out for the Reverol Rams. They are mean. You might want to give them a taste of their own medicine. When they're dazed, butt bounce to finish them.
Right. Just in case we... I feel like this was one of those things... There's a lot of these pieces of dialogue, which is just like, how do we explain how this works? Right, and then you can take them out real quick. The heck is this dramatic ass music?
We're going hiking on the trail.
Okay. Oh, whoa, my God. There appears to be some stuff down here. Right, free fruit. Okay, anything else over there? I think so. Yep. Bang. Well, that's easy. And I got an extra life out of him. What is this? Ah, damn it. I can't go in there and find the Spanish gold. Shit. Okay, I think now I need to cross this ice river thingy. Which I believe I'm not supposed to touch blue. I mean, it seems like the obvious thing. Actually, either that or it makes you... like makes it slippery or something. Let's see. Yeah, okay, yeah. It's just really, really fucking slippery. Gotcha. And then I assume jumping into the ice-cold water is bad. Jump over. I know your MO. Alright, where's the ghost? They wouldn't have given me that unless there was ghosts up front. There we go. Nums. Okay, any more? Probably not. Oh shit, avalanche. Bike. Oh Christ. There we go. Yeah, those guys aren't that hard. Okay. So I'm trying to think of like some recent news or just anything interesting that I've seen. I can't think of anything right now. My mind's kind of like directly linked in with the game here. Because I don't want to over... Oh, Jesus. I don't want to overuse brain power right now. Like, I'm using a whole... To be fair, I recently took some Advil. And, yeah, it is very, very much kicked in. Whoops. Okay, that's instant death. Cool. Well, good thing I hit a checkpoint. Anywho, Ooh, that was also very cool. Oops, Jesus. Anyway, what was I talking about? Oh, right. I took some Advil. That has definitely helped with the pressure in my head, but... still, I'm using as much of my brain power right now to just focus on the game. The remainder of my head... Oh, goddammit! Not working very well. Okay, try again. There we go. Let's see. I think I talked about this last stream, the whole, like, NVIDIA announced this, like, super powerful version of their graphics card, which is, like, 24% more powerful than the 1080. Now, see, here's the thing. I bought the 1080 knowing well and good that they were going to come out with an even stronger card for, like, the next generation. Like, I already... Oh, no! Fuck. How many lives do I have left? I've been getting fresh lives from this guy, right? So I've lost none. I'm just in a constant loop getting myself frozen. But anyway, I bought the 1080 knowing full well that, you know, something much more powerful was going to come out, like, very shortly after it was released. You know, like, I wasn't surprised. And then, of course, there's, like, they're going to come out with the 1080 Ti. Like, it's pretty obvious. Like, I understand that there were things that were going to be a lot more powerful than the 1080. And people kept on saying, just, like, you need to be careful. You might want to wait until they, like, officially announce the next card, you know, something like that. But I just kind of looked at that, and I'm like, I don't need 100% power, you know? Like, having a shit ton of power, that's kind of cool. But what I currently had, like, what I had before was kind of shit. So I was just totally happy with the idea of getting the 1080, just to start out, like, right out of the gate. Like, it didn't matter to me if there was going to be a card to come out 3 months afterwards. It's fine. Because, like, whatever I got afterwards, it would have ended up being an upgrade from what I already had. Now, on top of all that, the new card that they've announced is somewhere in the $1,000 range. I'm like, No. I mean, it's fine. If you have the money to blow and you really want to spend that much on a graphics card, by all means, go ahead and do it. I don't really care all that much. I was much more interested in the fact that, you know, just something that well-powered, like the 1080, has basically dropped to consumer-level pricing, and that is kind of amazing. Oh, damn. Please get up. Please get up. Shut up. Okay, doing all right. What's the next snow level gonna be? Is it literally just gonna be this? Oh, damn it. Well, at least I hit a checkpoint. Oh, here's another bit of fucking hilarious news. Now, like, AMD, I'm sure a lot of people know, like, AMG. No, not G. AMD. They recently announced a brand new card for the sake of, like, processing. They've always been known as kind of the company that makes cards for, you know, just producers, stuff like that. Son of a bitch! Are you serious? There, fuck, no, fuck you. No, I'm out. No. There. I fucking hate the ice in this level. That sucks ass. Okay, now what the hell do I do here? I assume go over to the shore, because I am not walking over this entire lake. Or do I have to? Or do I not have a choice? Fuck. Great. But anyway, yeah, they just recently released, like, this pro version of their graphics card, which, like, processes an absolute shit ton of graphics. And the price... Oh, goddammit. I love the token. Hatred. Oh, is that the exit? Oopsies. Didn't even see that. Damn it. Okay, you know what? Fuck it. Fuck the token. Let's just get out of here. I don't care. There's a token. Oh, good. Bang. Run. Run. Oh, abominable snowman. Anyway, like, I looked at the performance for this thing, and it genuinely has some, like, hardcore frickin' performance. But the weird thing, the thing is the price. There's no way me or you would ever be able to afford that. It's basically $10,000 per card. So, unless you're Pixar, you're not gonna be buying this thing. That's really what it comes down to. Oh, good. Oh, yes. Lovely. I'm happy. No. This is okay. I'm fine. I'm all right with what's happening now. Why? Is this going to be happening the entire level? Am I just going to be running for my life? Shit. Okay, I missed it. Is the entire level just going to consist of me running for my life from a snowball? Good. Just keep running. Oh, fucking hell. I feel like it's a little bit preconditioned. Oh, yoink. I feel like to an extent it's a little bit scripted based on, like, how well I'm doing. Ah, there we go. Got my ass out of there. Suck it. Grab some more of those. Anything hidden back there? I have no idea. And I'm willing to bet that I'm going to run into another one. Yep, there it is. Keep running, buddy! Oh yeah, these fucking icicles. They're... Okay, and then there's a chest. Oh wait, are these chests where those mazes are located? Nope, never mind. I thought I had, like, you know... Brainstorm, holy shit! Okay, do I have enough to open up this one? How did I even get there? Oh good, because I wasn't having a problem just walking over the ice before. Nope, now I gotta walk over gigantic pillars of ice. Yes. Here, I'm gonna quickly grab this. There. Boink. Oh my god. Oh shit, no! Well, good. Let's try again. Grab the extra life. I'm at 14 fucking extra lives. Are you kidding me? Why was this game so difficult when I was a kid? Like, now I'm just sort of... I'm collecting all of the extra lives, and I'm untouchable. Like, is it even possible to get a game over at this point? I'm not entirely sure it is. Okay. Don't bounce this time. Just try and run. There we go. Oh, no! What the fuck? How do you steer on that? Shit. Right, grab the extra life, because... Yeah, why am I so angry? So much of this is so inconsequential. I'm gonna just fall off right now, and I'll be alright. Like, who cares? Yoink. Oh my god. The please, camera. Alright. I do like how it brings back the concept of, brings back the concept of points. Because, you know, they matter. Like, whose line is it anyway? The entire game is made up on the spot, and the points for the game don't matter. Okay, we need to get the checkpoint. Oh, hi, how you doing? Oh, another extra life in case, you know, in case I didn't have enough flows. Oh. Okay, that was a tricky one. Plus one for you, game. Alright, I'm gonna... Ow, shit, oh. Not dead, bitch! So yeah, this guy. Fucking real? Oh, good on you, buddy. Failure. Alright, now I just fight my way through, not get hit by the avalanche. Apple up here. How the hell am I supposed to get the apple? Jeez. Knock. Oh, man. Okay, now just aim this correctly. Kind of reminds me of my top... Oh, oops. Kind of reminds me of my top five winter moments thing. Where I chose a whole bunch of my favorite winter sort of places in video games. Shockingly, this didn't make it because it's so generically winter, and the music's kind of giving me a migraine. Oh no! Oh no! Okay. Where the hell even am I? What is this place? Can I grab that? Oh! Whoa! Woo-da-da. Yay! Pac-Man level. Prepare for maze. Oddly enough, this is like my favorite part of Pac-Man World, just because it's gone back to the simple old style of Pac-Man. I can dangle deal with it. How you guys doing? What's up? Just like you're playing Pac-Man. This is what Pac-Man's supposed to be. Yeah, I don't know why. Like, 3D Pac-Man has always just kind of thrown me off a little bit. The 2D stuff? It's like, I'm cool with that. Yeah, I have, like, multiple lives. So I don't have to worry if I end up getting caught once. I wonder if I get some kind of, like, a cool bonus by completing this thing. I mean, I would assume so, but... Oh, shit! Damn it. Alright, it's okay. Okay, are these the last ones? Whoa! Yeah, finally! Okay, completed. Owie. Okay, now that's done. Oh, you go ahead, keep doing that shit. Here. Fine. Alright, let's get the hell out of here. That was a good interlude. Let's try and, like, get back to the game. Ow! What the fuck? How about fuck your ass? Like, what even are you? You're not even a ram. You're like some very weird mutant creature. Where the hell am I? Oh, wait, here. Okay, I got very confused there for a second. Boink. Boink. Okay. Camera? Oh, good. And now I'm running from the boulder again, right? Oh, good! And I'm also getting hit by spikes, yes! This is precisely what I wanted today, yeah. Hold up. Hold up. We can do this. Cool. But there's an extra life right at the beginning, because, you know, again, just in case the game was a little too hard for the 5-year-olds. I swear that giant, that thing, like, speeds up and slows down depending on how well I'm doing. Okay, don't care. As far as I'm concerned, I've already gotten the maze, so I don't care. I feel like a winner. And not getting all the items around here is not the end of the world. Whoa! No! Cheat! Ugh! Fucking depth perception! Alright, let's try again. And why should I care? Just like, yoink, 18 lives. Oh, wasted it. Who cares? It's kind of an inconsequential game. I was thinking about it, like, I was wondering whether or not I wanted to try and come back to this at some point. So I'm thinking about labeling this as a parted series, but yeah, I don't know if I'm going to be coming back to it anytime soon. It really does feel kind of inconsequential just to be playing it. Like, most of the challenge, once you get that many lives, kind of gone. Yeah, I feel like even this is a very slight variation of the original song. Bum 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 bum. Okay, how? What the fuck? Son of a bitch. Oh, I just thought of this. I'm wondering if my audio is at all, like, really weirdly out of sync with the rest of the game's audio. Like, that could very well be, that could be happening, because, yeah, the game is currently streaming to you at, like, a 125 millisecond delay. So, technically speaking, I'm probably talking right before anything happens. That tends to be the problem when it comes to playing these console games and routing them through. Okay. Getting close. Come on, let's do it. Can I have overshot it. Cool. Again, like, if the, like, what would really help out is if I had control over the camera at that scene. And if, like, that would fix the entirety of it. Like, just for me to be able to rotate the camera and be like, okay, where is it located? Right there? Alright, cool. And the issue is that every single one of the items that you collect in this game, whether it be fruit, whether it be dots, like, all of it is just some kind of a sprite. You know, there are very few actual 3D objects in this game. And that's okay, it's just, I really do expect that I have a little bit of control over what I see, like, just how to control the camera. And good God, this game does not allow you that freedom. Okay. Let's try this once more. Can we do it? There we go! Get the hell out of there! Watch the snowball fall the hell out. checkpoint? Seriously? I'm not even done with this level yet? Okay. Grabbed extra life. Oh, please don't tell me that there's another snowball that's about to fall through. Yeah, dude, fuck you. Alright. Well, at least I hit a checkpoint. I feel like I've heard that sound, like that ice sound effect from somewhere before. I don't remember from where. It just sounds like a really generic ice sound. Ow, what the fuck? Ah. Jesus. There's a ledge. And oh my god. Oh, what the fuck? Oh, okay. Did not expect that. Cool. Well, now I will. Oh, who cares? I could literally die 18 times and still win this level at this point. You know, I wonder if it saves how many lives you have. Because, like, if I shut off the game and then come back to it, am I gonna have, like, 19 lives? Whoops. I was doing so well. Oh, alright. What other recent news have I heard about? Well, they dropped the price on the Xbox One, like the original one, I think. And then the Xbox One Slim is out, like, I don't know if it's out soon or if it's out now, but, like, it's gonna be priced somewhere around $300. And that is actually not bad. Honestly, like, I've been holding off from buying an Xbox One for an extremely long period of time. And the reason why is just, you know, I was still holding that very, very heavy grudge with Microsoft in terms of their the mentality that they had to lock down everything. Like, you know, it's your console, you're allowed to do whatever the hell you want, you can have always-on DRM if that is something that you please. Same thing for video game developers, if you want to have always-on DRM, that's cool. Like, I'll be okay with something like that. But, oh shit. I went the wrong direction. Now, you can have as much DRM as you want. Okay, that's cool. But, just, like, you know, just so you know, I do vote with my wallet, and I will go ahead and completely skip over a video game, or a console, or just some kind of an experience, if some asshole decides they want to lock down their hardware, their software, whatever. Now, I'm fairly certain I've talked about this on several occasions on the stream. God damn it. And yeah, the whole, like, always on DRM thing that they tried to pull on the Xbox, like, I'm a little bit more lenient on it when it comes to games, because at the very least, that's a game, you know, like, that's a $60 thing that it's not really gonna matter all that much if it, but yeah, I don't know, like, I'm not really required to buy a video game. However, like, the whole Xbox always on DRM thing, that I was a little bit more upset with that, because yeah, that's an entire hardware generation that I was sitting there thinking, I'm gonna have to skip this generation, aren't I? Because, like, I can't deal with that bullshit. Like, I'm very much more interested in playing stuff on PC in that regard. Because, yeah, I don't want to be locked down. Like, I don't want to have my games always, always on DRM. Like, that was a decision that was very clearly made for people that were building games on their console. Like, they made that decision basically to make the game developers happy and not consumers. Like, consumers just did not like that in any way, shape, or form. Yeah, fun fact for anybody who doesn't know about it, piracy is not that big a deal. Like, it doesn't affect the industry quite as much as people think it does. For the most part, as long as you create a really good product and you release it in such a way that it's very convenient for for other people to buy it. Like, by all means, people will go ahead and they will buy it through the proper channels. It's when you decide to be a dick and make it that much harder to, like, play a game fairly on, like, the real hardware. That's when people start to leave. And, yeah, the Xbox that... I'm genuinely haven't decided to... Oh, goddamn. Oh, I keep forgetting what's coming up. God damn it. I'm happy that they decided to turn around on that decision, but yeah, that decision was not turned around on because they felt that they actually genuinely were wrong about it. Like, they turned around on that because they realized that they were losing all of their shareholders. And, like, every single person that owned a stock in Microsoft and, like, the Xbox branch. Yeah, they were starting to sell their shit, and suddenly they're like, oh, oops. Suddenly people don't want to associate with us. Hmm, that's interesting. And meanwhile, PlayStation was sitting there being like, oh, hey, you can totally trade your games around. Your games aren't going to get locked down on a specific console. You're not going to have to rebuy them for, like, a different console. You're certainly not going to have to, you know, you certainly have the option to also sell your game again. Son of a bitch. That's such a slippery area. Like, I think this is the one thing that's really bugged me about Pac-Man World 2. Was the whole, there were these, like, spikes of difficulty where something was ridiculous. But, yeah, sorry, I lost my train of thought there. I don't know, basically, I've said it before, Don Matrick, he had absolutely no right to be the CEO of a consumer, like, of just any consumer company. Because, holy shit, he is not good with dealing with customers. Like, not good. He does not understand the concept of, like, oh, hey, these are real human beings that we're dealing with here. Maybe I shouldn't treat them like trash, and maybe I should essentially force them. Oh, fuck. God damn it! I finally remembered to turn left in that at that turn, and then I forgot that there was that that right trap. Let's see. Now that's them. But, like, getting back to it, let's actually talk about some of the positive things about the Xbox One as of late. Xbox One is actually doing a hell of a lot better. Like, they've turned it around. They didn't put any of the always-on DRM inside the console. And I decided not to touch the console for a very long period of time because, yeah, if Microsoft is just going to come out of the gate just being like, we're going to put this feature in, and then just as in the ever-loving fuck just happened there. Okay. Never mind. But anyway, yeah, like, if Microsoft is just that quick to change their mind on something, who wants to bet they were planning on, like, maybe slipping the DRM programming back into the console sometime later on? Like, and at that point, I did not have any trust with them in any way, shape, or form. Understandably, like, I definitely did not want to work with a company that could very easily just decide to lock down my video games to my console, regardless of whether or not I buy them physically. But nowadays, I mean, it's been a while. Like, the Xbox has been out. It hasn't, like, they haven't really turned on that word yet. And as well as, they got Phil Spencer, who is now, like, the head of, you know, just the Xbox branch of Microsoft, as well as he's also trying to be the branch of a lot of different aspects of Microsoft as well. So, yeah, overall, like, I genuinely want to get an Xbox. Just, I don't really know. But the problem is that the newest Xbox that's going to be coming out, like the Project Scorpio that they're doing, we don't know if it's a new Xbox, but we are very certain that that's probably what it's going to end up being. Yeah, I just look at that and I'm like, oh right, fuck, I remember this. Blade Mountain. Now it's Pac-Man with roller skates. Okay, kick. Yeah, this will do. The problem is I don't think I... it's still difficult to control. I have a little bit more turning power, but not much. So yeah, again, the issue is that they came out with the Xbox One Slim, and honestly, if they didn't announce that they were doing Project Scorpio, I think I'd be a little bit more interested in buying an Xbox One Slim. But then they dropped the news that they were working on Scorpio, which could very well just be another Xbox. It's like, whatever, I don't... So, cool, my generation is about to be... You know, like my generation is already about to expire. So why the fuck would I buy an Xbox One at this point? Like, who cares? Like, at this stage of things, it's a lot easier to just wait and watch and see when, like, the new Xbox comes out. Or at the very least, as soon as we find out what Project Scorpio is, if it's not an Xbox, alright, I'll buy an Xbox One Slim. But everybody and their dog has just kind of looked at that, like, yeah. It really does seem like they're just making another Xbox, except, you know, this one that actually renders 4K. Because technology kind of took the entire... And technology kind of took the entire industry by storm, and it's just like, 4K, 4K is a new thing. But the thing is, the 4K shit didn't really become prominent until the Xbox One and, like, all the new consoles came out. And by then, it was way, way, way too late. That and VR. Like, there's no way consoles of this generation are even going to be able to handle the kind of VR that people have been testing. Oh yeah, it's not surprising that they would go ahead and start working on the next console. It does kind of suck, though. I would have liked to get the Xbox One Slim. That is so amazing, isn't it? Like, it's basically the Xbox One, except they have, like, honed and refined the technology involved with building it into a much smaller unit. And then on top of that... Okay. And on top of that, the Xbox One Slim is, like, not only is it smaller, but it's also got all of the wiring and everything involved with playing an Xbox in, like, very compact inside the machine itself. Like, the power brick is actually inside the Xbox One Slim. Like, that is amazing, isn't it? Like, we've never had an Xbox where the power brick was not a thing, and the Xbox One Slim is totally that. Well, shit. This might take some time, people. Grab a drink. Yeah, I was totally interested in getting one, but... Like, I was watching the Xbox conference, I'm like, oh, hell yeah, I totally... Like, you know what? It's been a while. I think the Xbox is perfectly fine. And it's like, I'm gonna go and buy a new one. And then they released Project Scorpio. It's like, what? Okay. Way to shoot yourself directly in the crotch. Nice. What are even these floating boxes for? What the fuck? Okay, don't fuck up. Got it. All melons collected. You mean the one? Add another life, because that makes sense. It's a necessity, I guess. Okay, don't run into any puddles. Jeez, more extra... The most valuable piece of tech... You know, the most valuable thing that you can collect on the road. An extra life. It's so valuable. Why are there so many of them? Okay. I'm actually doing real well at this point. Yeah, see, why are there so many fucking extra lives on the road here? Oh, shit! Damn it. Okay. Okay, what I don't like is that there wasn't a checkpoint at any point in that. So I'm gonna have to do this flawlessly. Oh, I don't care. And then, of course, like, let's also discuss PlayStation, I guess, since we've, you know, we've stroked Xbox long enough, we might as well. Now, PlayStation, like, I can totally see the appeal of PlayStation, and they have a lot of exclusive content for them. A lot of stuff I've genuinely been interested in playing. But for whatever reason, I cannot wrap my head around it. Like, just, I don't know. I mean, first off, I'm a huge PC gamer nowadays, so buying an Xbox or a PlayStation is a little bit moot point for me anyways. Christ. Ah, hey! We're going to see a maze. Very nice. Okay, what are we doing here? Pac-Man on ice skates. The newest Broadway hit. Yeah, you do. I don't know, all these Pac-Man boards. I mean, like, it's one of my favorite things just because it finally takes, it brings Pac-Man back into a Pac-Man video game. At the same time, though, all the boards are a tad tiny, eensy-weensy bit generic. Not a ton, but enough that you're sitting there like, this kind of feels exactly the same. Alright. Now, I will say, like, one of the shittier things that I've ever done, I really wanted to try and get into the PlayStation, and one of the easiest ways I could possibly see me doing that was buying the PS Vita. And before anybody judges me on that, it was when the PS Vita was actually fairly new. I saw that PlayStation Vita was happening, and it's like an HD PSP. I'm like, that's kind of cool. And out of anything, like, out of all the things I could potentially do to try and, get myself into the PlayStation market, I think starting me off with a handheld might actually help me out, like, a lot. Because, yeah, it'll get me in tune to the buttons, it'll make me remember, you know, just like, you know, that X, circle, square, shit. You know, like, lack of numbers. And then, like, you know, there are some PlayStation exclusives that are located on the PS Vita, and I felt like that could really well put me in a good position. Like, I could finally get into playing PlayStation-type games that way. That was my thought. Level complete. Now that was my thought, and then nothing came out for the PlayStation Vita, and very promptly failed miserably on that front. So yeah, I wasn't anywhere, like, I wasn't any more intrigued with the idea of buying a PlayStation unit after that. Even though I know PlayStation Vita is, like, oh, by the way, here's the basically the exact same fucking thing again. Except with less nets. And I think it's a tad bit harder. Trying to recall how it's done. I think I'm supposed to roll into him. Boink! Oh my god. That is very, very treacherous. I seem to remember that this boss fight gave me a lot of trouble. And I think it was very, it was specifically because of the fact that there's, like, very little room to be able to hit and maneuver.
You're just playing hard to get, aren't you?
He's like, you're undead. I have 23 lives. I feel pretty confident in myself on this one. Yeah, you go ahead, keep doing that. Not like I moved or something. Okay. Boy. Alright, this is no way to treat a lady. Why'd they have to make Picky so frickin' girly? Ouch it. Bang! Oh shit, 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 shit! Ah! Now see, that's what makes this really difficult, because it's very easy to fall off. Oh, wait! Nope. This boss fight has checkpoints somehow. That's not that bad, Ben. Bang! Alright, we're halfway done. Anyway, and then, again, there's just, like, the bad luck of our family owning a PlayStation 2 and not many games to go with it. To a point where, like, we already owned, you know, like... I don't even know how we managed to own so many game consoles when I was younger. Like, we weren't exactly a rich, you know, a rich family, but we still owned, like, all of the major ones, like PlayStation, GameCube, and Xbox. So, I mean, like, when you own both GameCube and Xbox, like, and you've, like, put so much time and effort into Xbox, because I was playing a whole lot of Halo and Halo 2 at the time. I'm still playing with you. Okay, cool. Good for you. Oh, Jesus. When you put so much time and effort into all the other ones, like, it just feels kind of silly to do anything with the PlayStation. Which sucks, because, yeah, there are some genuinely good stuff on there. And actually, looking at it from hindsight, I actually think that the N64 was the loser when it came to its generation. Like, the PlayStation was like the obvious winner. And unfortunately, yeah, we ended up having to pick the N64. And not that I hate it or anything. As a matter of fact, I think of it very fondly. But, yeah. Looking back on it, I think my life would have been a little bit more enriched if I played on a PlayStation. Oh well. Hindsight, 2020. Sorry. If I've coughed, like, directly in the microphone once or twice, I apologize. Again, I am down with the sickness. Oh, you son of a bitch. Come on, bring it on. Oh yeah, and then I think Blinky has the exact same robot, except it's, I don't know, like, it's like a lava version of it. Oh yeah, I can dance at this part. Pac-Man. The golden apple. Is that like the apple of Adam and Eve? I feel like I probably shouldn't eat that or touch it. I'll be cast out of heaven. All right, well, I think this would be a pretty good spot to end it for today. I mean, like, we defeated three bosses, and all that we have left is Blinky, and then, like, the final boss, which I don't remember being all that difficult. Yeah, I don't know why, like... I think, okay, here's the thing. I don't think the game was difficult when I was a kid. I think it was frustrating. That's what it's gotta be. Like, cause yeah, I don't, with how many lives you collect with this, I feel like just, I got really frustrated with a lot of the pitfalls. And trust me, there's one particular level that's coming up real soon that I hate with a passion. So I think, you know what, I think I will come back to this, but I don't know if it's going to be next week. Maybe it'll be, like, the week afterwards or something. Aside from that, I do think I should look into buying some more GameCube games, because I do remember there was a lot of stuff that I played, and I think that'd be cool just to try and play a few more of those, especially on the stream, like, revisit them, sort of. Alright, that'll be enough for me tonight. I'm gonna give my vocal cords a good old rest, because I probably shouldn't have been projecting all this time when I have bronchitis. It's not a throat infection, it's mostly lungs, but still, they're all interconnected, so this was stupid on my part. I'm gonna try and get myself some hardcore antibiotics and just rest up. And then, I don't know, I'm probably not gonna be better by, like, Saturday or Sunday, but... at the very least, I have those days kind of cut out for myself, so... That'll be it for tonight. Thanks for coming out, everybody. If you want to catch this stream after it is done, you can go to my YouTube channel. I'll be uploading it there shortly after this entire stream is done, and also after it's done being processed. And I stream on Saturdays, Sundays, and Wednesdays, all of them at 7 o'clock. On Saturdays and Sundays, I play more recent video games. Like I mentioned, I've been playing Doom a whole lot. And then on Wednesday, it's more retro stuff. So, yeah, I guess I'm going to count, like, you know, the GameCube, Xbox, PlayStation 2 generation is retro at this point. Although maybe not too much PlayStation 2, because that console was still relevant, like, 4 years ago? Something like that. Anyway, I'm done for today, so see you later, everybody. Well then. Lovely.